Well, hello everyone. We're back again with another segment of yoga, but this time it's going to be a different rendition. We're going to do chair yoga today. So I want you to, wherever you are, grab something you can sit on. Make sure it has no arms to it, okay? So that we can have free range to be able to move our arms freely. And when you get that chair, I want you to remain seated. Take a deep breath. You're going to straighten your spine and make sure you're not laying on the back of the chair. Placing your arms on your knees, palm to the ceiling. We're going to begin by rolling our head toward the right. In a circular motion. And I want you to gently just observe your breath. Beautiful. And when you're facing back toward the seat, I want you to go in the opposite direction, rolling toward the left this time. Beautiful. You're going to come back up to a neutral position and keep breathing. To gently roll our arms forward. You can match that with your breath as well, inhaling as they roll up, exhaling as they roll down. And this time you're going to roll them up and roll them behind you. When you're ready, you're going to pause, relax your shoulders. Just going to grab the ends of your chair and just continue to slouch your spine inward. Breathing, relax your shoulders as you grab the end of the chair. And then you're going to pull your weight forward, arching your spine, then doing a nice chest opener. We're going to do that again. Cave your spine in. Now we're going to push forward. Last time, you're going to gently cave your spine in. And then gently push forward and looking up. Beautiful. You come back to a neutral spine. And this time we're going to take our right hand, place it on the left corner of your chair. You're going to take your left elbow and just hang it over the backs of your chair. And you're going to gently look over that left shoulder. This is a twisted chair pose. And you're just breathing. And you may notice that you want to tense up that right shoulder. I want you to gently relax it and continue to breathe. When you're ready, I want you to come forward and go to the opposite end. So you're going to grab with your left hand the right corner, front corner of your chair. Take your right elbow and just relax it on the back of the chair and twist over that right shoulder. And you may be tensing up this left shoulder. I want you to gently relax it as you do a twisted chair pose.
keep breathing and watching your breath. Beautiful.
I'm going to come back to center. This time you're going to take your right hand, place it on the left corner of the chair, just holding the front end. Take your left hand, raise it up gently. And do a side pose, just allowing your spine to lean over to the right side. Breathe. Just opening up that space down the left rib cage. Beautiful. When you're ready, you gently come back up to center. Allow that arm to come back down. We're going to do the opposite side. So this time you're going to grab with your left hand the right corner of the front chair. Float your right hand up. And you're going to side plank to the left side. Beautiful. And I want you to breathe here. When you're ready, come back up. And place your arms back on your knees, palms facing the ceiling. Just center your breath again. This time we're going to pull both of our arms towards the side, just allow them to dangle beside the chair. Now you want to inhale, lift as they rise all the way up toward the ceiling. Breathe. And I want you to gently dive forward as they come back down to the sides, and you're leaning your torso all the way over until your chest is pretty much laying in your lap. Okay, so this is phase one of this position. Now, if you want more of a stretch, you can raise both hands. Find the backs of your chair. Your arms can reach. That's fine. You can have a bit more of a stretch in your upper body. And if this doesn't feel okay to you, gently bring your hands back down to your feet. And then we're going to gently lift up, straighten your spine until you're in a halfway position, okay? Now we do this position a lot in yoga. The halfway position is really just to make sure you get a straight spine. When you're ready, you're going to collapse again. Hands to the floor or hands behind you on the upper side of the chair. Beautiful. When you come up, we're going to do that again. Let go of your hands. Come back up. Your arms are rising to the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale, diving down. Chest goes to your lap, arms to the floor, rope wraps around the back of the chair. Beautiful. Now we're going to swing through to a half back, straighten your spine. When you're ready, collapse back down. Breathe. When you're ready, gently rise back up into your neutral position. Beautiful. Now we're going to gently lift that right knee, placing it on the seat of the chair. Okay? Now you're going to wrap your arms around your shin. breathe. The opposite foot is just flat on the floor. Now you're going to take your left arm and place it right around that knee. Your elbow goes on the back of the chair as you do a gentle twist over your right shoulder. You're breathing as you allow your breath to rise and fall against that inner thigh. Now, if you want more of a balance challenger, you can let that foot off the chair and allow it to float in midair. So you have both positions and you can modify them to fit whatever feels best. And when you're ready, come back to center. Puff your hands around your upper foot. Now you're just going to gently stretch that out in front of you. Beautiful. This time I want you to match your breath. Inhale, straighten. Beautiful. Inhale, lower. Now do this again at your own pace, matching with your own breath. Close your eyes. Inhale, lift. Exhale. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Beautiful. Now we're just going to gently place our foot back down. Let's do the opposite side. Lift your left leg up, place it on the seat of your chair. Wrap your arms around that shin and breathe right here. I want you to watch your breath. And when you're ready, gently wrap that right arm around that left knee. Place your left arm over the back of the chair and do a twisted chair pose. Beautiful. Come back to center. Cuff your hands around the tops of your feet. And now you're going to gently stretch them out into a straight leg stretch. And then bend them back in. This time, matching your breath like we did on the opposite end. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, bend. Beautiful. Let's do that again. Inhale, matching it to your breath, doing it at your own pace. You do not have to do my pace at this time. You just want to match this movement to your own breath. Beautiful. When you're done, place that foot back on the floor. Okay, now we're going to do some more poses. At any time, you can always modify this to make yourself feel a little bit more comfortable. Yoga should never be painful at all. Okay, so you want to move with ease. So you're going to turn to the right. Your right foot is just hanging over the side of the chair. Okay, and this is your warrior one. So you're going to bring the opposite leg on the other side of the chair, and your foot turns parallel, okay? A wonderful thing about this chair position is you will be able to hold up your body without having the weight of your body to hold up in the Warrior One position. You're just gently going to turn forward just like you would in any other warrior position and raise your arms up into a Warrior One. Beautiful and simple. Now find that as you do this Warrior One, you're able to pay a little bit more attention to your alignment instead of focusing on holding up your weight. So in this position, you want to make sure your torso is facing the direction of your front foot, okay? So you don't want to be doing this. You want to gently turn your body all the way to the right side. Beautiful. When you're ready, I want you to gently open up to Warrior Two. And you're just gently balancing your hands in front of you and behind you. Breathe. When you're ready, you drop that back hand toward the leg and just float the front hand upward. When you're ready, swing back into your Warrior Two. Beautiful. Swing back into your Warrior One. And then we come back out of that position. Bring our legs back in front of us. Take a breath. We're going to do the opposite side. So you're going to swing your left leg over to the left side of the chair. The right leg goes behind you. We're going to turn our leg completely straight facing that side, lifting your arms up into a Warrior One. Now you can turn your back leg horizontal. Probably feels a little bit more comfortable in the chair position. You're just going to breathe. When you're ready, you want to float out into a Warrior Two position. Make sure your shoulders are relaxed, that you're not holding up like this. Drop your shoulders and breathe. When you're ready, you can gently turn behind you, placing the right hand on that right shin, and lifting the left arm in front of you toward the ceiling. You're looking up into a reverse warrior. Just breathing. Beautiful. Come back out to Warrior Two. Back into a Warrior One. breath. You're going to take both arms, wrap them around the chair behind you, just on the sides. You're going to gently allow your body weight to fall forward. Stretching out your entire shoulders, your arms. If you can let go of your body weight enough, you'll feel it all the way down to your hips. Breathe. Gently rise up, inhaling. All the way up. We're going to do that again. Gently allow your body to fall. Your elbows are straightening as you stretch out. Allow your body to get heavier and heavier, the deeper your stretch will go. Okay, beautiful. You're gonna come out, turn both feet to the left side. Okay, and this is great for people who want to do a back bend, but don't have the support to hold them up. You're just gonna lean backwards. You can support yourself as you position. And voila, bring your arms toward the floor, and you're in a back bend. If you want more of a stretch, you can lift one leg, not both. You want to be able to support yourself with both hands and one foot on the floor. This is a more advanced position, but it's still very doable if you have no, you know, issues with your blood pressure, obviously. If you do, just lean back up and just stay in this position. Okay? But if not, you're free to do it. Just do what feels most comfortable for you. Switch legs if your leg was in the air. Just switch to your left one. Then, when you're ready, bring your foot back down to the ground. Support your arm as you reach back up. For our last position, we're just going to do a twisted chair pose, grabbing both hands on the back and twisting behind you, breathing. This really feels good on this side of the shoulder blade right here. Now we're going to swing around and do the opposite end. Beautiful. Now when we do our inward meditation, Shavasana, you can just bring your your feet upward into a meditative position, or you can leave your feet down on the floor, okay, and lay back on the backs of the chair. So whatever position you want to do is fine. Your palms are facing toward the ceiling, and I want you to take a deep breath. just allowing your body to inhale and exhale freely. And just being the observer. Drop your shoulders. Allow your body to sink into the chair. Eyes are closed. We allow our minds and our spirits to feel elevated. To feel a higher vibration that only yoga can give. We relax into that vibration of joy. And we allow it to circulate throughout our entire bodies. Relax. Relax your jaw. We harness that high vibration and that high energy, and we take it through us, with us throughout the day and throughout the week. Namaste. Hope you guys enjoyed this simple routine that you can do anywhere as long as you have a chair. Sit comfortably and just get into your own yoga flow. So I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time.